Здравствуйте, студенты. Hello, dear students. Меня зовут Вероника. My name is Вероника. And I am a professional Russian teacher. And of course, I am a Russian native speaker. And today, at this Russian lesson, we are going to continue talking about declension of Russian personal pronouns. And we will talk only about plural forms. Мы, вы, and они. But before we start, I would like to ask you if you like my lessons, if you are really helpful for you, please support my channel. You can donate me. You will find the link for donations in the first comment. And of course, you can hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you in advance. Спасибо. And now we start our lesson. As you already know, in Russian language, we have six Russian cases. And now let's talk about the Russian pronoun мы. In English, it means we. And we have in a nominative case, we say мы, мы. And this form you can find in the dictionary. But all the rest forms you will not find in the dictionary. But let's talk about them. First, I read them. And after, I will show you all of them in the context, so you can better understand Russian grammar. So in the nominative, we say мы, мы. In genitive case, we say нас, нас. In dative case, we say нам, нам. Accusative, нас, нас. Instrumental, нами, нами. And the last prepositional case, нас, нас. And in English, you have only two forms, we or us. And in Russian, we have six forms. And now let's practice these constructions in a context. So I read this Russian text and after, and of course you have the English translation, and after I will explain why did we use this or that case in this specific phrase. So let's start. Это мы. Знаете нас? У нас есть большая компания. Все хотят работать с нами. Нам это нравится. Что вы думаете о нас? Okay. So, это мы. Here we use nominative case because it is subject of the sentence. Знаете нас? Do you know us? After this preposition знать, to know, we have to use object. And if we talk about direct object in Russian language, we have to use accusative. So it is нас, accusative form, accusative case. У нас есть большая компания. This is a very interesting Russian construction. У нас есть, we have something or someone. And when we talk about this Russian construction, we have to use the Russian preposition у. And after this preposition always goes genitive case. So it is quite tricky, you see. Нас and нас in, it is the same form in two different positions. They look the same, but they mean different things. Yeah, this is accusative and this is genitive. So be very careful. Все хотят работать с нами. That's easy. When you see this preposition с, you think that most probably it goes with the instrumental case. In this meaning with, it's always instrumental. Нам это нравится. This is quite tricky, again, construction, because in English you say, we like this, and the subject is we in English. But in Russian language, this is a very tricky construction. Нам это нравится. So the subject in Russian is это, and the нам is in dative case. So when you see this verb нравится, you think that it should go with dative case. That's it. That's Russian logic. You just need to memorize it. I know that it's quite difficult to understand, so the best way is just to memorize it. Что вы думаете о нас? Что вы думаете о нас? That's quite easy. When you see this preposition о, about or of, it means that it goes with prepositional or. After or, you have to say prepositional case. That's it. And we talk about next personal pronoun. It is вы. It means you, plural form. Nominative case, вы. Genitive case, вас. Dative case, вам. Accusative, вас. Instrumental, вами. And prepositional, вас. So in Russian language we have six forms of this pronoun, and in English you have only one, you. That's why Russian language is quite difficult if you speak English as a native speaker. Okay, now let's try to practice. Вы идете на выставку? Можно с вами? Я много слышал о вас. У вас уже есть билеты? Нет? Куплю и вам, и себе. Буду ждать вас. Okay, so вы идете на выставку. Вы, it is subject, because it is an active person in this sentence. Можно с вами? Can I come with you? Or can I go with you? In this construction, we have to use the preposition с, and as you already know, after с goes instrumental if it means with. Because this is quite tricky Russian preposition, с. It can mean from, if we talk about time, for example, from next week, со следующей недели. And also, normally, this с means with, okay? And in first case, if we talk about time, it goes with genitive. And if we talk about meaning with, it goes with instrumental. And let's continue. Я много слышал о вас. This is the preposition о, about, and it goes always with prepositional case. А вас. У вас уже есть билеты? You know this construction. У вас есть. You have. And after this Russian preposition у, you have to use genitive. Нет. Куплю и вам, и себе. That's interesting, again, construction, because here we skipped or we missed the word билеты. Куплю билеты и вам, и себе. So билеты, it's direct object. Вам, it's like I will buy it for you. In this situation, you have to say Dative case, because you are the addressee, yeah, куплю вам. Okay, so if you talk about addressee in Russian language, normally you use dative case. Буду ждать вас. Буду ждать вас. I hope that you understand this practice, and we continue with the last Russian pronoun for today, and it is они. Nominative case, они, они. Genitive case, них, них. Sometimes this N can appear or can disappear. It depends on the preposition that stands in front of this pronoun. Dative, ним, ним, or им. Yeah? Accusative, here I forgot, wait a second. Here I forgot to write this N. Let's try to do this. Here also should be N, like, wait a second, like this one. Yeah, it can be них or их. Again, it depends on the preposition that stands before this pronoun. Instrumental, ними or ими, and prepositional, них. In English, it means they or them. So look how many forms we have in Russian. We have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10 forms in Russian and only 2 forms in English. Okay. And now let's try to practice them in a context. Wait a second, I will show you another page. Это они. Посмотри на них. У них хорошая семья. Давай познакомимся с ними. О них пишут в журналах. Думаю, им нужны хорошие друзья. Это они. It's nominative subject. Посмотри на них. Look at them. It is the object. Look at them. They are the object in this sentence. I look at them at an object, yeah? So we have to use accusative case here. У них хорошая семья. У них. This construction, you know, after у, you use genitive. Давай познакомимся с ними. Let's get to know them. After this long Russian verb познакомимся, always goes this Russian preposition с. And after «с» you have to use instrumental. О них пишут в журналах. They are often written about in magazines, or magazines write a lot about them. Yeah, so пишут о ком. Here we have to use after about prepositional case. Думаю, им нужны хорошие друзья. I think they need good friends. With this construction, somebody needs something or somebody needs someone, we use нужен, нужна, нужна, нужны, and we use all these kind of modal verbs in Russian with dative case. So if you want to say, I need money, for example, you say, мне нужны деньги. You don't say, я нужны деньги. No, you say, мне нужны деньги. Okay, my dear Russian learners, I do hope that this Russian lesson was somehow interesting and useful for you. If you found something interesting here on my channel, you already know what you need to do, like hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and of course you can donate me. И увидимся скоро. See you soon. Пока-пока. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Хорошего дня.